All right. My everyday routine when I use LITPro at the track is really easy. It's fundamentally these things: fastest lap, lap count, and seat time. I have goals for all these things because I know how I know the tracks in Southern California where I ride. I know what a good lap time is. I know if slightly different conditions are going to, I should be getting a better time than I am. I know all these things and I keep track of them every time I come to the track. So let's go over each one individually. Fastest lap time. This is just for the day of all the sessions. What was my fastest lap time? I'm also later going to show you, but I'm going to look at what time of day I got that fastest lap time. That's really important to me. Lap count. This is just how many laps total I did the day on the day at. This is just for the vet track because I also rode the main track, as you can see down here, but we're not counting that for now. So that's just my lap count at the one track and then total hours. That's actual seat time on the track. So how much seat time of actual riding time that I put on the track doesn't include if I pause or tip over or anything like that. So these are the fundamental building blocks and metrics of LITPro and improving at motocross even. It's everything kind of comes down to these things, is getting the load in, getting the training time in. So if you click on a row here, you're going to come and just see the sessions for the day at this one track. So this is the filter right here. It's Wednesday, March 13th, Cahuilla Vet Track. You can click edit, change all these filters and see a different track, different day. But automatically, if you click on that row in that previous screen, you're going to come here and see that filter applied for that row you were on. Here's my sessions. On the left, we have the little numbers, the number one right there. That's saying that's my fastest session at this track all time. So if I had not gotten a PR this day, then I wouldn't be seeing that number one, you know, Matt, on this filter. On the right here, we have the lap count for each of these individual sessions. And then across the top here, we have seat time matching this filter. So the gray bars are kind of, I got some riding in that week, but it doesn't match this filter. I'll show you that in a second. Then we have seat time. This is just my seat time over the past 12 weeks. So I'm going to show you a little bit more about that in a second. But I'm going to tap here on my session with my fastest lap time. So I can see just down here that I did an 8-lap moto. I can see the layout of the track. I can come here. I can see my heart rate for this first lap. I can see top speed, distance, basic stuff like this. This is just my segments. The green segment here is when I got my fastest segment for the lap. And I can come down here to my lap 99, and I can see what my theoretical fastest time would be, a 126, which is just a little bit faster than my 127. So let's just focus on my actual fastest, though. And then you can come over here to the session. You can see your heart rate zones. This is a really important one right here, looking at your consistency score. So consistency is how consistently you can ride, no matter if there's lappers, no matter what happens on the track. Don't hurt yourself trying to do this, but try and get a good consistency score. And this is something you can work on. It doesn't require all out speed. It just requires being consistent on the track. A lot of times it has to do with fitness, focus, all great training attributes that can be worked on every time you go to the track, that can be worked on safely and are fun. So focus on those things. This is a real basic thing. So here's, go back to the very beginning again. So I can go ride and I can easily just focus on a few core things: my fastest lap time, my lap count, and my seat time. I'm gonna jump in here, go to my fastest session, and I'm gonna just jump straight to consistency score. That's not a great score, I'll tell you right now. It's a score out of 100, and I want to get closer for my skill level. I'd be happier if it was closer into the 70s range. So that can easily just be my entire day at the track. I told you I was gonna come back. If you just tap on you in the upper left-hand corner, this is another fundamental thing, is we've set a goal for everybody. We'll tap on this right here, a 12-week target. So we're giving you a goal to get 10 hours of seat time in the past 12 weeks. And you get this. So if you get 10 hours of seat time in the past 12 weeks, you get this thumbs up status. If you get any seat time in the past 14 days, you keep this color ring. So these goals are derived from just our kind of an average user. So setting a goal just past what the average user in the LITPro ecosystem does. So if you're getting seat time every 14 days or a little bit more than that, you're going to be on track to achieving the status of the thumbs up, which means you got 10 hours of seat time in the past 12 weeks. If you look at me right here, I've got 5.3 hours of seat time in the past 12 weeks. So I'm a little bit past halfway to that goal. And it's just because these weeks here, so this is 12 weeks ago. I didn't do any riding the first of the year, had an injury in my knee. I don't know, probably some work travel, something like that. Got a little bit more consistent, almost 2 hours of seat time that week. And then here's these last 3 weeks, I hurt my shoulder snowboarding. So not doing too great on my own seat time goals, but this is an easy way to keep track of these things. So get seat time in. It's the fundamental building block. Get lap times in. Try and work on PRs. So notice this little PR icon right here. Personal records. Focus on these things, and it's a fun way to use LITPro. It's the most simple. It's the building blocks. Getting seat time, getting on the track. This is what everybody should be working on at the